This tutorial will take you through an introduction to the matching phase of the planning stage in MSOFT. As you can see here, we have a DICOM file. In the 3D view, we can see that this DICOM has an upper and lower jaw. This CT was done according to the M-Center protocol. The space between the upper and lower jaws is clearly visible. This is specifically requested in the protocol, and we'll soon see why the jaws need to be separated. In this phase, the matching phase, we're going to match the STL file to the DICOM. We first click on Step 2, second button from the left on the button bar at the top of the screen. Click once more and navigate to the folder where your file is. Select the file you want to upload. It will take a few seconds for your STL file to upload. The next thing we're going to click on is the 3D view. Then we select the upper jaw and remove it. You can now see that the upper jaw was removed, but all the occlusal areas of the teeth remain. Had the jaw been closed, we wouldn't be able to see the occlusal area of the teeth clearly. This is very important to us in this step of the process. I'll now put back the model and we can move on to starting the matching phase with the semi-automatic system. Now let's click on the rough positioning button. You will see two windows side by side. On the left is the STL file window, which you can see me moving here. On the right is the DICOM. Next, we'll click on the pick a point option because we'll need to pick between 3 and 7 points. I like to select a point that I can see both on the CT and on the STL file. This should be a mark that will always be visible. On this dentition, you can see that I've selected a point between the two central incisors because I can see them clearly. Let's add some more points. Here is another point I've added where I can see this hole. At this point, we'll move on distally as far as we can to this point in the developmental groove. And I'll do the same in the DICOM view as well. You can now see that a green match indication is showing on the bottom of the screen. This means that we have enough points now for the system to continue matching automatically. Now we'll click on the green match button, and then the system will do the matching by itself. After these steps, you will see a dialog asking you to decide whether or not to accept the position automation made automatically by the software. You can choose to either cancel the calculation, accept it, or advance to change the threshold and recalculate. We're going to select accept. In the lower screen here, we can see that the matching was done quite well. However, I feel that it could be improved a bit, so I'm going to pull this down. I recommend that the STL should be within the borders of the DICOM. Let's hit the space bar so we can see a zoomed out view. I use the activated areas to move them. Using the left mouse button, I can either push or pull or turn. At this point, I'm satisfied with the matching. I can also take this red plane and move it forward to make certain that everything is done correctly. I can see in the front that everything is seated perfectly. Now I click here on the Import Scan Data button in order to approve and finalize the model matching process. We now have the model matched to its DICOM. Thank you for watching.